John N. Calhoun, Iowa Senator and Iowa Nice Guy. He is so nice, in fact, that he loves his wife and she loves him. But how do we know this? Pet names, for one, are a great way to show that significant other that you care enough about them to be mildly uncomfortable in public. Calhoun's letters are usually started affectionately with "My Dearest," but he decides to spice this one up with "Dear Honey Chili." At first, this confused me, as I thought that the word was pronounced "Honey Child." It then reminded me of one of my favorite shows, Here Comes Honey Boo Boo, as Mama June will often call her daughter "Honey Boo Boo Child." So I did some more research on the historical context, and my roommate tells me that it's actually pronounced "Honey Chili." This kind of pet name tells us, like Mama June and her Honey Boo Boo Child, Calhoun and Dorothea have a very stable, loving relationship. Calhoun tries to persuade Dorothea to have a talk with her father. At the time of this letter, Dorothea's father is 68 years old, which is reasonably above the contemporary life expectancy of 63. He says that Dorothea's father ought to take more care of his health, and then ought to realize his dad isn't young anymore, and see that he doesn't work so hard. At first, this sounds like an insensitive quip about a dead grandfather, but the more reasonable conclusion would be that Calhoun is trying to use Dorothea's 85-year-old grandfather as an example. He continues by saying, "Poor Glad, she surely has plenty of worries, doesn't she?" Glad is Dorothea's sister, and we see that Calhoun is trying to appeal to Dorothea's sense of emotion and logic in the same letter. Given Calhoun's background as a lawyer, this isn't the least bit surprising. One interesting line of the letter is when Calhoun says, "We had an orientation lecture this morning." That means getting yourself straightened out, or acclimated. This is especially weird, as Dorothea is illiterate, and Calhoun wouldn't use a more complicated word like acclimated to explain orientation to a more vacuous reader. As it turns out, the word orientation was not used to describe an introduction until the year 1942, the year that the United States entered World War II, and only 1 year off from the date of this letter. Presumably, orientation gained that definition as soldiers were drafted into the military and introduced to its lifestyles.